Hello, dear friends. We continue to analyze the variants with traps in the Evans Gambit opening. We studied the move d takes c in the past video and made a conclusion that white got a strong attack in this case. And in this video, we will analyze the game with move d6. C takes d and h6, mistake. Black loses a tempo, better knight f6. After h6, white has an initiative. Queen b3, attack on the f7 square, queen e7, knight c3, bishop takes c3, queen takes c3, bishop d7. Black loses the second tempo, better knight f6, e5, knight e4. Queen e3, knight g5, and black holds the position. Let's go back. After bishop d7, white hits in the center, e5, the trap. If d takes e5, black falls into. Better d5, black sacrifices the pawn and gets a counterplay. Bishop takes d5, queen b4, queen d3. White is unprofitable to exchange queens when attacking. Knight e7. Black's position more active, but white has an initiative. Let's go back. After d takes e5, bishop a3, e takes d, knight takes d4, queen f6. Black's position worse because white has a strong attack on open files E and D and on open diagonals. Black has a big problems. Rook E1 check, knight E7, knight takes C6, queen sacrifice, queen takes C3, rook takes E7 check, king F8, rook takes F7 check, king G8, knight E7 check, king h7, and bishop b2, very strong move. If queen takes on b2, then bishop d3 check, bishop f5, bishop takes f5 checkmate. Therefore, bishop e8 was in the game, and bishop d3, white sacrifices the second bishop and put a checkmate. Queen takes d3 and rook takes g7, white's win. Very impressive attack and the final. On the 18th move, black could play king e8. Then rook e7 check, king f8, rook takes d7 check, queen takes a3, rook f7 check, king g8. If king e8, then rook e1 check with win. So king g8, rook f3 check, king h7, rook takes a3, b takes c, bishop d3 check, g6, rook c1. White has an extra piece and should win. So, knowing the traps in the opening, you can get a strong attack at the beginning of the game. We continue in the next video. See you!